Hello students, I am Dr. Akhilendra Kumar Singh, Assistant Professor, Department of Psychology, DAV PG College, Varanasi. Today I am here to discuss about the cattle factor analytic approach of personality. This topic belongs to the personality, psychology of personality for the student of MA second semester psychology. I have already prepared one video lecture on Alport's theory of personality, and this is the second video lecture on trait and type approach of personality. If you will talk about the biographical sketch of Raymond B. Cattle, British American psychologist, was born in March 1905 in England, and when Cattle was 9 years, at the age of 16, Cattle enrolled at the University of London to study physics and chemistry, and in 1929 he received his doctoral degree in psychology. And he worked as a school psychologist for the 5 years. He was the researcher who were working on the factor analysis model, as Spearman was using this factor analysis in mental ability, and Cattle was using this method in structure of personality. In 1937, Cattle was invited by the Thorndike in New York, and after that he was settled there. He has published more than 500 articles and 43 books. In 1997, he was awarded a Lifetime Achievement Award from American Psychological Foundation. If we talk about the Cattle approach to personality traits, his study of the personality was to predict how a person will behave in response to a given stimulus situation. Subject were so-called normal people, because his aim to study the personality, not to treat. So Cattle was conducted on normal subject, and Cattle theory of personality did not originate from any clinical setting. His approach was rigorous, scientific, and relying on observation of behavior and masses of data. He has a hallmark of approach in the treatment of data. He submitted them to a statistical procedure called factor analysis, which involved assessing the relationship between each possible pairs of measurement taken from a group of subjects to determine common factor. Cattle referred to those factors as a trait, which he defined as a mental element of the personality. Only when we know this someone's, that person will behave in a given situation. So you all are aware about the factor analysis. Factor analysis is a data reduction techniques where underlying variables were from the different tests were examined or identified, and those underlying variables, mostly called factors, were named. So these factors were named as a trait here in Cattle approach. Cattle defined trait as a relatively permanent reaction tendencies that are the basic structure unit of the personality. Cattle classify traits in several ways. First of all, we will discuss about the common traits and unique traits. What are the common traits? Common traits possessed by everyone in to some degree, like intelligence, extraversion, gregariousness. Common traits are universal, and that all people have a similar hereditary potential and are the subject to the similar social pressure, at least within same culture. So common traits are possessed by everyone in some degree. Maybe some have high level of intelligence, some have low level of intelligence, but everyone has something. And second is the unique trait. We differ because of our unique traits. Those aspects of personality shared by few other people. So these are the particular apparent in our interest and attitude. Our interest and attitudes are generally different from others. For example, one person may have a consuming interest in genealogy, whereas another have a passionate interest in civil war, battle, baseball, or any game. Another classification of traits was proposed by the Cattle is surface trait and source trait. Surface traits, we can say that this is response tendency that can be observed in various situations. So surface trait is a response tendency. Another one is source trait. Source traits are stable and permanent traits that are the personality derived by the method of factor analysis. The factor that summarizes the correlation among surface traits are source traits. So several surface traits may formulate the source trait. Next typology of traits is constitutional traits and environmental mold traits. Constitutional traits and environmental mold traits. Source traits are classified by their origin as constitutional traits and environmental mold traits. Source traits that depend on our physical characteristics are known as constitutional traits. Originate in biological condition but are not necessarily innate. So constitutional traits are originated in biological condition but not necessarily they are innate. For example, alcohol intake can lead to carelessness, talkativeness, slurred speech, but these are not innate tendency of the individual. Individual mold traits are the source traits that are learned from the social and environmental interaction. Like a career military officer shows a different pattern of behavior from the normal civilian. The interaction between person and situational variable are the main cause of these environmental mold traits. Another classification is ability, temperament and dynamic traits. Cattle identifying 16 source traits which were grouped in three categories: ability traits, temperament traits and dynamic traits. Ability traits are those traits which explain how efficiently we will be able to work towards a goal. Like our level of intelligence will affect the way in which we strive for our goal. Temperament traits describe the general style and emotional tone of her behavior. For example, how assertive, easygoing, or irritative we are. These traits affect the way we act and react in a given situation. And third one is dynamic traits, the driving force of our behavior. They define our motivation, interest, and ambition. So whatever we are doing, that is due to these dynamic traits, because this provide a motivation for us. Source traits are considered as a basis of personality. In cattle system, source traits are the basement of our personality, just as atom are the basic unit of physical world. He argued that psychologists cannot understand or generate laws about the personality without describing precisely the nature of these elements. So, on the basis of intensive factor analytic research, Cattell identified 16 source traits as the basic factor of personality. Source traits can be assessed by 16 personality factors, 16 PF, a well-known questionnaire developed by Cattell. Cattell presented the source traits in bipolar form. Cattell later identified additional factors. He designated temperament traits because they relate to the general style of and emotional tone of the behavior. He gives an example: excitability, zest, self-discipline, politeness, and self-assurance. These are the temperaments. If you talk about the dynamics of the personality, so Cattell discuss about the dynamic traits, which is considered as the motivating force. Cattell described dynamic traits as concerned with the motivation, which is an important issue in many personality theories. Cattell believed that a personality theory that failed to consider the impact of dynamic or motivating forces is incomplete, like trying an engine but failing to mention what type of fuel will be used to run this engine. Cattell proposed two kind of dynamic traits, urges and sentiments. So urges, ERG, urges, use this term Cattell to denote the concept of instinct or drive. Instinct, drive, these terms were used in Freudian psychology. Urge is a permanent constitutional nature source traits that provide energy for goal-directed behavior. Urges are the basic innate unit of motivation. In Cattell factor analytic research, he has identified 11 urges. These are anger, appeal, curiosity, disgust, gregariousness, hunger, protection, security, self-assertion, self-submission, and sex. If you talk about the sentiments, so Cattell proposed that sentiments are the environmental mold source traits that motivate our behavior. Sentiment, because it's a result from learning, and we learn and can disappear, so that it's longer important to a personal life. So Cattell later called learned traits as SEMS, which stand for socially shaped urgic SEMS. Influence of heredity and environment on Cattell research has been also examined. Cattell showed great interest in relative influence of heredity and environment in shaping the personality. He investigated Importance of heredity and environmental factors by statistically comparing similarities found between twins reared in twins reared apart, non-twins siblings reared in same family and non-twin siblings reared apart. So after collecting the data, Cater concluded that overall one third of our personality is genetically determined and two third of their personality is determined by social and environmental influence. Cattle has personality and cattle proposed six stages of the personality development. First stage is infancy, which is between the birth and 6 months, and main developmental task of this age is toilet training, formulation of ego, superego and social attitudes. Second stage is childhood. It's a lie between 6 to 14 years, which is main developmental task of this stage is independence from parents and identification. Years. Third stage is adolescent. It ranges from 14 years to 23 years. And main developmental task of this age is independence, self-assertion and sex. Maturity ranges from 23 years. And main developmental task of this stage is start with career, mess and family. Fifth stage is known as late maturity, which is ranging from 50 to 65 years. And main developmental task of this stage is personality change in response to the physical and social circumstances. And last one is old age, which is denoted to 65 plus year. Adjustment to the loss, career and status were the main developmental task of this. If we talk about the assessment in Cattle's objective measurement of personality used three primary assessment techniques, which he called L and T data. L data is known as life record, measured of the behavior in everyday life situation, like school performance. Q data in terms of questionnaire form, self-report. Unaware the relationship between their response and the certainty. Such kind of situation is experiment. The traits assertiveness can be expressed behaviorally, such as fast tempo in arms shoulder movement or fast speed of letter comparison. The 16 personality factors as 16 PF is a well known questionnaire or inventory developed by the Cattle, and it was derived from the factor analysis of 60 SKU data. However, Cattle was concerned with the possible self-deception in questionnaire response and the wisdom of psychiatric patient self-rating. So later he relied on OT data, OT means objective data, in factor analytic research. Without the CPF, this is the bipolar questionnaire, which mentioned the 16 personality factors. First factor is reserved. If we talk about the reserved, low score show warm and high score show outgoing. First factor warm, low score show reserved and high score show. Second factor is reasoning, low score show low intelligence. Third factor is emotional stability. Fourth is dominance. Fifth is liveliness. Fourth is rule conscious. 7th is sensitivity, 8th is vigilance, abstractedness, 10th is privateness, 11th is apprehension, 12th is open to change, 13th is self-reliance, 14th perception, 15th tension, and 15th is vigilance. So these are the 16 factors bipolar in nature. If we talk about the and variability, Kettle did not view people as a static organization. The Alport, he also looked that the dynamic. He highlights two other determinants of action, that is states and role. States are the fluctuation in emotion, and roles prescribed by interpersonal relation in discrete socio-cultural circumstances. So traits, states and interact in complex way to produce a behavior situation. All was also very important for the personality research, but still there are some limitations. Critics has been criticizes on the hard to 16 of Kettle personality factors. Kettle told that he is more concerned about the objectivity of the personality test, but not as objective as Kettle had thought. His research or his theory is not as objective as Kettle thought. He has also proposed too many factors so that they cannot be accurately assess the personality.